This wedding is not going to happen.
Greetings! Are you a wedding guest? You may not believe it, but I am too. I haven't always been a fox, you know. I'm Joe, the best man. Nice to meet you. I can't remember how I became a fox, but I bet if I return to the Great Hall, I'll remember something. Come on! Wait, I'm starting to remember what happened. Ah, now I remember. Some evil witch put a curse on us all. I turned into a fox. Edward radically became young again. His wife-to-be, Rose, became a flower and has disappeared. A witch crashed Edward's and Rose's wedding. She cursed everyone, turning us into animals and objects. I remember something else, too. The witch mentioned something about a clock and her curse. Yes, that's right. The clock is broken, but if it strikes 12, the curse will be broken, and Edward can marry Rose. Can you help us?
Thank you. Hmm.
guard the Rose Princess. No one may so much as gaze upon her. Understood?
I didn't think there were any people left in the castle. I'm Mr. Jefferson. I was a famous conductor hired for the wedding, but now I'm just a broken piano. I happen to have one of the magical parts of the enchanted clock. For a little favor, I'd be happy to give you it. Would you be so kind and find one lost golden decoration and a music sheet page for me? Take this. It will help you find the things I lost. Thank you. You're so kind. I don't have much, but please take this for all your help.
Oh, it's Sweet Rose. Their love story is just magical. Edward and I were hunting and got a little lost. While wandering in the forest, we met a couple of girls picking berries. That's where Edward met Rose. It was truly love at first sight. Today should have been their happiest day. Oh no, look, Rose is fading. We must hurry. The fewer the petals the rose has, the closer she is to death. And when Edward transformed into a little boy, we must find all the clock details and fix the clock fast.
Thanks, but I don't really like cheese. I'm actually Josephine, the maid of honor. Actually, perhaps you might be able to help us break the curse. Well, I can help you brew a potion to stop Rose from fading. Take this list and gather these ingredients for me.
Thank you.
The potion is ready. Just raise the dome and pour it over Rose. That should slow her withering and buy you some time to break our curse. It was such a lovely wedding, too, before everything went wrong. You're our only hope. We're all counting on you.
Thank you.
give up now. The castle won't be released until I allow it.
Thank you.
Whee!
Thank you.
I'm Prince Edward. I was here on holiday with my family, but all the grown-ups disappeared. I ran to that cliff to look for them, but the bridge collapsed and I couldn't get back. Thanks for saving me. And I'm sorry for breaking the rose. I just wanted to see it. Here, take this to make up for it. I'm going to the castle.
You, stay here and guard the house.
Thank you for finding my son. I thought all the guests had turned into something. But you're still human. We're all counting on you now. Find out what happened, and try to return us to human form.
I am Amber, the Mighty Witch. How dare you get in my way? It's time I taught you a lesson.
Hello, traveler. Oh, don't let my appearance fool you. I'm Tom, the gardener. I used to be a regular old human. I have a small favor to ask of you. My wife became a gnome too, but I don't know where she's gone. If you can find her, I'll reward you with a magical gear. Thank you kindly. My precious angel is with me again. I was so worried. There was some mean woman running around in a real snit. I bet it was she who enchanted us. Well, here's your reward.
Long ago, I lived in this hut. I was just a young witch at the time. But one day, I managed to save the king from a severe illness. Since then, this ordinary forest witch became friends with the most powerful family in the land. I was invited to learn from one of the most renowned witches in the world, so I had to leave the kingdom. I was young and happy, and I was about to become a mother to a wonderful baby. But this meant the end of my magical path. What could a forest witch with no wealth even hope to offer a child? The king and queen gave me a way out. They couldn't have children and offered to adopt my baby boy. I agreed, and the royal couple was in seventh heaven. The boy, who I named Edward, was taken into their care, but I continued to track his destiny. Through my crystal, I saw his future, marriage to a lovely girl, followed by their horrible death. Some jealous person had cursed the young couple, so I did the only thing I could think of. I returned to the kingdom and interrupted the wedding. My spell turned everyone into animals and objects. Now, I must find the person who cast the spell and reverse their magic so Edward and Rose can marry.
Oh, happy day! You rebuilt me. Oh, please, don't be angry at Amber. She hasn't done this out of malice. You know, Miss Amber and you are on the same side. You're both trying to disenchant the castle. But she's trying to remove an even darker spell, too. She found out the newlyweds were going to die right after the wedding. Someone had cursed them. Amber is in the royal library now. Maybe you can find her and join her?
Hey, who's there? Can't see a thing without my gargoyle glasses. No sight, no admittance. Thank you. I see you're a guest. Well, lucky for you not to become a giant gargoyle. Oh well, go on.
Thanks for reuniting my family. Take this as a reward. Don't you dare refuse.
I see you, little Joe. I'm amazed by your tenacity, and I'm finished with this petty feud between us. My snowman told me everything. You know I'm Edward's mother. I only want the best for him. Before disenchanting the clock, we must lift the curse from Rose and my son. I'll give you the book I found in the secret section of the library. It lists all the ingredients needed to lift the curse. You go and find them. I'll keep watch here.
Thank you.
Whoopee! Yeah!
Hello, friend. I wanted to repay you for saving me. Take this, and please, don't be angry with me for what I did.
Thank you.
walk in the woods was life-changing for us. First, Rose and I became frightened. Then a horseman emerged from the woods. It was the prince himself. I got a strange feeling in my heart the second I saw him. I knew it was love. But the feeling wasn't returned. The prince was gazing at Rose. Prince Edward and Rose looked so happy. They couldn't help but smile. But my heart was burning. I was angry with the entire world. The final straw came when I was made maid of honor for their wedding. As we were getting ready, decorating the castle with flowers and bows, I couldn't ignore the ugliness filling my soul. I took a portrait of the couple and personal items from each of them, Edward's cufflinks and Rose's hairpin. Magical talent ran in our family. I knew how to cast a hex, and so I did. Immediately after, I regretted what I had done. The spellbook and all the things I had gathered were lying in front of me, screaming my guilt. Envy and anger blurred my vision. I wished 100 times I could undo the spell, but I simply don't know how.
Well, well, look who it is, the troublemaker, Miss Josephine, in person.
I'm so sorry for what I did. There is no room for hatred and envy in my heart anymore.
You're lucky my helper and I learned how to lift the curse. Soon we'll put everything back to normal. So, I suppose I can forgive you for the sake of the happy couple.
Thank you.
You've lifted the curse from Edward and Rose and saved them from a terrible fate. I am so happy to see only love and happiness in their future. Now we just need to lift the other small curse. Go to the main hall and repair the clock, then scatter the dust of time over it to disenchant the castle. Edward, my son. That's right. I'm your real mother.
We all became humans again. Prince Edward was so happy to meet his mother and make up for lost time. Josephine was forgiven and continued to make amends to her friends on their wedding day. What a happy day that was, and what a banquet! The food was paw-licking, I mean finger-licking good. All's well that ends well. Best wishes to the newlyweds, and Merry Christmas to all!